Hello there. Let's open our calendar. Wish me luck. Oh yes, it's a Commander Legends booster that comes with amazing art. Wrath of God with alternate artwork released in From the Vault Annihilation. Amazing artwork done by William Murray. But let's read this card first. It's a white sorcery. Casting cost 2 colorless and 2 white mana. Destroy all creatures. They can't be regenerated. Flavor text. Legend speaks of the lost coastal polis of Olantin, whose inhabitants' hubris enraged the sun god Heliod. I like set variants that broaden the lore of the magic multiverse. This art shows Heliod, god of the sun, from the Zeros block, in the middle of destroying the polis of Olantin with his legendary spear. It's like time stands still for a moment. In the middle of the impact, you can see stone structures, houses, pillars, but also people dissolving into nothing but dust. Back to our calendar. Okay, we are trying to open the booster very gently. Let's see. Pumpster with card draw, not bad for sealed. Artifact and enchantment removal. Life gain ramp. A small dragon. Cascade artifact creature. A treasure maker, and our first anchor of the day. First uncommon, Hunter's Insight. Very nice card draw for Voltron decks. The superb mono black control popper staple Kurumbaji Witches, with artwork by Seb McKinnon. A creature with flying, too expensive, and what? Infamous Jeweled Lotus, hated and loved. Fantastic music. In my opinion, that is a fun card for underwhelming commanders that cost like 5 mana plus, since that card enables you to compete with the more spicy commanders. Extra legendary, the shocking Elf Horror. Malkin, a very solid partner commander that also ramps in blue. And a green cold foil, very rare. That pack was amazing, at least in the end. And a Monarch token. Subscribe and ring the bell.
Dum da dum da dum ba dee die. Now it's time to say goodbye.